How are you, grade 10? Today we're going to complete our lesson in chapter 8, lesson 8.6, vectors. We're going to complete the lesson and we're going to solve the exercises. Let's start together. I'm going to refresh your information what we took last session. We talk about the vectors and what is the vector. Vector is like a line segment, but it has a certain length with a certain direction. And the vector has initial point and terminal point. And I can write the vector like this. A, B, and up, I'm going to write like this. This sign, okay? This is the sign of the vector. Okay, and I can write it in the component form as, and I told you this two new brackets for the component form of the vector, and x and y. What's x is the horizontal change, and y is the vertical change. Okay, and I told you if we want to write the component form, and in a figure, I can count the units, and for the right it will positive, for the left it will be negative, up it will be positive, down it will be negative. And if you give me two points of the vector, how can I get the component form? By subtracting the terminal point minus the initial. Terminal minus the initial. And we said that we have a new word, which is magnitude. What's the magnitude? It's the length of the vector. And I can write it like this. Okay, let's write it again in front of you. Here, a line and a line, and inside it, A, B as a vector. Okay, and if you want you to draw a vector in the coordinate plane, you are going to start with the initial point, which is the origin, and the terminal point is the ordered pair of this x and y. Okay, and if you want the magnitude, what is the magnitude? The magnitude is the distance formula. Use the distance formula, square root of x2 minus x1 or power 2 plus y2 minus y1 or power 2. Okay, and we took the direction of the vector, which is the angle that the vector made with the horizontal line or the positive xx. Okay, and of course I can write the direction by this way or by relating to the compass directions, which is north, south, east, west. If he tells me N30E, that means it's between N and E, north and east, between north and east, but take from the north 30 degree. Take from the north 30 degree. Okay, and if I want to get the angle, how can I get it, or the direction of the vector, how can I get it? I'm going to draw it in the coordinate plane. Okay, as we said, this is the origin point and this is the terminal point. Then I made here from the terminal point perpendicular to xx. So this triangle is right triangle, so I can use a trigonometric ratio, and I have here 5 and 2, which is opposite to angle A and adjacent to angle A. Opposite and adjacent, opposite over adjacent, I can use the tan. Okay, so tan A equal 5 over 2. How can I get the angle? By tan inverse 1, tan minus 1. So I get the angle. Okay, that's what we took last session. Today you are going to complete. The two vectors are equal vectors. If they have the same magnitude, take care of this. I have two conditions here. The first condition, same magnitude. Okay, same magnitude. The second condition is same direction. So not only the magnitude, or not only the direction, I must have both of them, magnitude and direction. Okay, so the vector u equals the vector v. Equal vectors don't have to have the same initial point and terminal point. Look here, this is my initial point, it's not the same, and the terminal point is not the same. Okay, so it's not important to have the same initial point or terminal point. Okay, if I get the magnitude, and take care of this, quotient, take care of this, AB, as we said last session, AB, vector AB, not equal BA, because, because what? These two vectors don't have the same direction. We said equal vectors must have same magnitude and same direction. Okay? Magnitude here of U, vector U, equal magnitude of vector V. Two vectors are parallel. Parallel, I have only condition, one condition. One condition, which is A, if they have the same direction or they have opposite direction. Okay? They can go like this or like this, but they are parallel. They are parallel. Okay? So they can be in the same direction or in the opposite direction. So they are parallel. Okay? Parallel. They may have different magnitude. Okay? But the parallel vectors, I'm looking for the direction only, not the magnitude. They may have different magnitude. For example, the vector W is parallel to vector X. Okay? Equal vectors are always parallel vectors. Of course, vector U here, equal vector V, they are equal vectors, and at the same time, they are parallel vectors. But parallel vectors are not equal. Take care of this. Parallel vectors are not equal. Okay? Very good. Let's complete. I have here example. Identify equal and parallel vectors. Look here in the figure. What's equal and what's parallel? I can see that AB is equal the GH. Okay? Same direction. And same magnitude. Same magnitude. And look here, AB is parallel to what? GH. Very good. And CD is parallel to EF. Okay? And take care of this. The equal vectors, here we said it's equal. The equal vectors are parallel. Okay? But these two vectors are parallel but not equal. But not equal. Very good. Let's complete. The resultant vector. What is the resultant vector? It is a vector that represents the sum of two given vectors. It's the sum of two given vectors. If I have vector U and vector V, I want to get their sum. Their sum, I'm going to start from the initial point of the first vector and connect it with the terminal point of the second vector. Again, initial point of the first vector. Initial point of the first vector. And what is this point? It is the terminal. Terminal point of the second vector. So, the new vector here is the sum of the two vectors. Or, the resultant vector. The resultant vector. Okay? Initial point, I can say it as a tail. And the terminal point, I can call it as head. So this method is called head-to-tail method. Head-to-tail method. This is head, and this is tail. Okay? Head-to-tail method. Very good. I have another method, which is parallelogram method. How to make it? I'm going to make parallel to this vector. From the terminal here, and I'm going from the terminal here, I'm going to draw another parallel to vector V. So at the end of vector V, I'm going to draw parallel to vector U, and at the end or at the terminal point of vector U, I'm going to draw parallel to vector V. Then I'm going to connect the initial point here with the point of intersection of the two parallel vectors. This line is called what? Resultant vector, which is the diagonal of the parallelogram, which is what? Diagonal of parallelogram. To add vectors numerically, by numbers, add their components. Add their components. So if U is x, y, x1 and y1, and v, vector v, x2 and y2, let's make it, this is 1 and this 2, and this is 3, and this is 4. So u, vector u plus vector v equal x plus 2, x, x1 plus x2, 1 plus 3. 1 plus 3 is what? 4. Y1 plus y2, 2 plus 4. 2 plus 4 is what? 6. So this is the resultant vector. The resultant vector. Okay? Okay. Let's take exercise. Open your exercise book with me and let's solve it. Here, in this, write each vector in component form. And he give you a figure. That's so easy to give me a figure. I'm going to draw dashed line like this. Okay, from here. Then I'm going to count the units. For the x, I'm going to get the x component. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the x component is 5. Very good. What about the y? The y component. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4. But what? Take care of this, huh? Here, PQ. Here, to the right, so it's positive. What about the y? The y is getting down, getting down. So it's what? It's negative. So y equals negative 4. Y equals negative 4. So how can I write the component of PQ? I'm going to do the bracket, okay? And 5. And negative 4. Okay? Very nice. What we said about this, if I have the 2 points, if I have the 2 points, how to do it? I'm going to take the terminal minus initial. Terminal minus initial. So, negative 10 minus negative 1. Okay, this is the first component. What is the other? Negative 3 minus 2. Okay. Can you solve it? Here, it will be positive. Negative 10, positive 1. So it will be negative 9. And here, negative 2, negative 3 and negative 2 are negative 5. Okay. You can solve number 3 as a homework. It's just the same like number 2. Let's see here. Draw each vector on the coordinate plane. So easy one. We said that the initial point is the origin. Then I'm going to get the ordered pair 5 and 2. Here this is 2 and this is 4 and this is 5. Here 5. 5 and 2 here. So this is my point 5 and 2. Okay, this is my point 5 and 2. This is my terminal point. Then I'm going to draw the vector. Okay, this is initial point and this is the terminal point. Of course, you can do 5 and 6 as homework and also 7, 8 and 9. Okay, sorry, we didn't finish it yet. He want also to give him the magnitude, huh? What is the magnitude? Remember? What is the magnitude? We're going to get square root x2, which is 5. 5 minus 0, which is 5 power 2. Plus y2 minus y1, 2 minus 0, which is 2, to the power of 2. So it's equal what? Square root of 25 plus 4. 25 plus 4 is what? 29. And of course, I can get it by calculator and approximate it to the nearest tenth. To the nearest tenth. This is how to get the magnitude. Okay, you can solve 5 and 6 as homework. Okay, let's complete here. Draw the vector and get the direction of the vector. Let's see here, 4 and 6. This is 4. This is 4. Okay, and 6. 2, 4, 6 here. So this is my point, the terminal point. And this is my initial point. I'm going to connect them. Then, to get the direction, what I'm going to do? I'm going to make a right triangle. Okay? Here, this is 4 and this is 6. So, to get the direction, it will be 10 minus 1 of 10 minus 1 of what? Opposite over adjacent. 6 over 4. And of course, you can solve it by your calculator. Okay? And solve 8 and 9 as homework. Here, what is the equal vectors? Equal vectors, Equal vectors, I must have same magnitude and same direction. EF and CD, it's so easy. EF and CD. And don't forget to write the sign of the magnitude. The sign of the vector. Okay? This is the equal vectors. What about the parallel vectors? Of course, EF and CD are parallel. And who else? GH and what? AB are parallel. And also AB and EF, and also AB and CD, all of them are parallel. They may be on the opposite side, but they are parallel. Okay, so AB also parallel to EF. Okay, and also AB with CD. Okay. All of this I can write it as parallel. Okay. This is for now. Thank you very much, grade 10. See you later.